lack of comprehension. It is true that music has the advantage of communicating directly, not having to rely on the help of words. But it also has a major handicap. An apprenticeship is required in order to be able to understand the relationship between what is heard and what is written on the score. Nevertheless, the listener can locate landmarks and get his bearings. There does exist in contemporary art a reference to tradition. Sometimes it is unpleasant to come up against something that at first seems entirely new. And it is only later on that we become aware of the continuity of a culture's permanent values. A chronological presentation of the major composers or the important trends of this century does not really answer the listener's questions, as he does not react in such a rational and systematic manner. His reactions are more of a general and sensitive nature. Does melody still exist? Does harmony really still exist and not just cacophony? Has rhythm not simply disappeared and been replaced by chaos? By replying to these questions, by suggesting a few keys, we hope to show you why we love this music and make you love it too. I don't like this music. It has no melody. This is what is often heard about contemporary music. But it is meaningful to know that the same thing was said about Beethoven's and Wagner's music when it was heard for the first time. Today, we are all familiar with classical music. When listening to it, we understand perfectly well what is going on. The phrases are symmetrical. They are built with identifiable periods, just like poetry that was written in rhymes, in verse, with a certain number of feet. The nearer we came to the 20th century, the more we tended towards dissymmetry and complexity. Painters, for example, began to divide color and invented new perspectives to enrich their language. Composers were led to enlarge their melodic vocabulary and thus made it more difficult to understand. In order to illustrate 20th century melody, we could make a comparison with a trek. Before setting out, the hikers need to study their maps and get their bearings. In other words, they need to familiarize themselves with the trails, the difficult passages, the distances between stopovers. All these details make for the originality of the trek. I think that in order to appreciate contemporary music, one needs to set out in the same way and find one's landmarks. And if you are willing to come along with us on this trail towards melody, you will discover that melody really does exist. I have chosen four works in the following order. Three Japanese lyrics by Stravinsky for the syllabic style of the melody. My own Marteau sans maître for its ornamental vocal style. Schoenberg's Serenade and Berg's Chamber Concerto for their continuity with romantic melody. Each illustrates the permanence of melody in contemporary music and underlines the diversity of the composer's approaches. We'll start with Stravinsky.
Yes, one last time, please. Can we have the little note, despite the difficulty, can we have it absolutely regular, condensed and regular at the same time? The first piece is based on an obstinately repeated melody. Stravinsky varies it with differing intervals. Then later he adds chords to give a quite different coloring, but in which the identity of the melodic phrase is not lost. On the contrary, it's underlined, and that's how this first piece develops.
Très piano aussi.
Very piano.
Voilà, ça c'est bien comme ça.
That's
it. Refaisons le même endroit, s'il vous plaît.
That's fine. Now, well, let's start from the same point again with the right hand of the piano, the piano part, and the first violin. That's it. Absolutely straight at the end. In the second piece, he uses a similar technique. For example, here is the melodic vocal line. This he doubles with a zigzag instrumental line. And when the two are overlaid, it is perceived much more as a change in tonal color. In the third piece,
des cellules.
He uses cells of only two sounds.
Mais cela suffit.
But that is enough to make a melody when the two tones answer each other with two tones of another instrument.
Et du reste, nous trouvons
in any case, we find the same thing in Wagner, in the third act prelude of Parsifal.
Seulement dans Wagner,
except with Wagner, the melodic line tends toward the consonant interval always, whereas with Stravinsky, the melodic line remains on the dissonant intervals. We have to manage to meld the wind instruments together, and if you play too much vibrato, they won't go together. You practically have to create a sort of etched line with no coloring at all. That's it. It's a cold tone at the beginning. Same thing, rather cold at the start, like that. You hold off any expression until later. I'll tell you when the tonal range shifts entirely. Otherwise, on the contrary, all that should be plain. Not too much vibrato in the voice. Not too Japanese either. More reserved at the start. We'll begin again. The character has to be held back entirely. Later, in the middle of the piece, there is something that blossoms out, and then it reverts to the first thing. That very arabesque. And now you can change your tonal scale completely. More expressive. Even more expressive. There, suspended. And again, as at the beginning. No vibration at all. Quietly. Yes, that's it.
Cette mélodie que l'on vient d'entendre,
this melody that we just heard is a very ornamental one.
Et comme dans le Stravinsky, où entre les notes de la mélodie, il y avait pas.
And as with Stravinsky, where melodic notes come in with little notes, here there are groups of little notes.
Pourquoi cela? Eh bien, parce que la mélodie est entendue seule.
Because the melody is heard alone.
Il n'y a pas d'autre dimension que cette dimension.
And there is only this horizontal dimension.
Et pour compenser,
I would say a melody unwinding. And to compensate for the absence of a chord accompaniment, this melody has to be, in itself, sufficiently rich to be listened to for itself. This recalls two traditions. In our Western civilization, Gregorian chant, which was also sung without accompaniment, and where the figures, which we call melismatic, were sung and formulated in a way that we suppose was highly ornamental.
Là, nous avons des témoignages alors tout à fait directs.
And also we have good direct examples, the traditions of the Far East, Japanese and Chinese songs, which also have a long tradition of ornamentation in the vocal line. Small things.
Sophie, j'entends pas très bien le groupe que vous avez dans la deuxième mesure.
I don't distinguish clearly the group that you have to do in the second measure.
Il y a une note, je sais pas qui.
There's a note.
Elle est jouée, mais elle est un peu.
It sounded, but it gets away somehow.
Oui, c'est ça. Oui, oui, c'est ça. C'est là. Oui, c'est le si bémol. Voilà. Oui, faites-le un peu moins vite, mais vaut mieux que ça sorte
égal. A little slower.
Parce que là, on entend. Voilà, c'est ça.
But it's better if it comes out voilà. Without vibrato.
Merci. Autre chose maintenant pour
another
la voix,
thing,
si possible,
for the voice, if possible.
Dans la mesure 6,
in measure 6,
la seconde petite note.
The second little note, not too slow.
La, ah, et pas yadada, ta, ta. C'est la seule chose qu'il y a. Aussi doux que vous pourrez. Hein? C'est trop fort. Et c'est comme un écho,
as softly as you can, that's too loud, like an echo of the voice.
Voilà, c'est ça. Une mélodie ainsi écrite, quand on l'entend,
a melody written like that,
on l'entend indépendamment
when it's heard,
de toute autre chose.
Is heard independently of all other things.
Tandis qu'une mélodie tonale, qui obéit à d'autres règles,
whereas a tonal melody which follows other rules,
même si on ne l'entend
pas, is heard with its accompaniment,
ce qui fait qu'on l'entend
even if it is not heard.
Je dirais qu'une mélodie qui reste seule comme cela,
I would say that a melody that remains alone like that,
en quelque sorte,
in a way has
un centre de gravité.
No center of gravity.
Tous les centres de gravité possibles.
Or one can imagine every possible
si
center of gravity.
Si je prends une comparaison avec la peinture.
If I could make a comparison with painting, it's like a change in perspective.
Les peintres ont travaillé
for a long time, painters
réaliste.
Worked with a realistic
puis,
perspective.
Au fur et à mesure, la peinture a tendu
and
à
then, little by little, painting divested itself of this kind of
mais
perspective,
a créé des perspectives
creating different perspectives, which
qui entrent parfois en conflit
sometimes
avec
enter into conflict with the object itself.
Vous avez entendu le thème.
That was the theme from a movement of a serenade that Schoenberg called Variations. This theme is revealed by the clarinet absolutely alone. All the same, there are reference points for it, as in a traditional phrase. In fact, there are symmetries. This is the main one. It's in the first part of the phrase, in the second.
Donc on se rend compte qu'il y a
so we realize there is a certain construction, hence we can remember this phrase.
Du point de vue d'un accompagnement, on serait bien embarrassé.
From the point of view of accompaniment, one would have a hard time saying just what accompaniment it needs, because there is no automatic way of adding one.
Tandis que si vous
yet,
écoutez
if you listen
cela,
to this,
le sens est déjà sous-entendu dans cette phrase.
The sense
pour une
is understood. It's obvious what harmony will complete it.
Que Mozart a écrit.
The one that Mozart wrote.
Et mélodie et harmonie.
Melody and harmony unite to have a total understanding. Whereas in Schoenberg, this melody is free of any attachment. I used the word harmony and not accompaniment.
Mais j'aimerais employer un autre
but I'd like to use a different word now.
Polyphonie.
Polyphony.
Cela peut paraître très savant,
that might seem terribly knowing, but it's only an overlaying of melodies.
Et j'ai choisi un exemple dans la sérénade de
I've chosen an example from Schoenberg's Serenade, the same movement variations.
On peut distinguer trois plans.
Where three levels are clearly distinguishable. The first,
le premier qui est fait par les deux clarinettes.
Made by two clarinets.
Naturellement, c'est le plan principal.
Naturally, it's the main one,
clarinettes se partagent
since the two clarinets share that theme.
Alors, Alain, 25, quand tu as le glissando,
Alan, at 25, you have a glissando.
Et pas
instead, do a porté with the lips,
simplement
not
la...
by fingering.
Voilà, c'est ça, c'est tout. Le deuxième plan
the
est
second
assumé
level
par
is taken by the mandolin and the guitar
en notes plus rapides
with more rapid notes.
Et donc nettement distinct du premier.
So it's quite distinct from the first.
Un, deux, trois. Non, non, attention, il faut que ce soit l'un après l'autre. Vous avez mi, ré, la,
do, non, non, place, be careful, it has to be one after the other.
C'est pas en place.
It's not in place.
23, encore une fois. 1, 2, 3, 4. Mi, ré, fa, mi, do, do. 1, ré, fa, fa, do. La, sol. Non, non, le la, sol vient sur le troisième temps. 1, 2, la, sol, c'est ça. Prenez cette mesure-là, 25. Mi, ré, la, do, la, sol. Do, si, la, si, do, si, la, ré, do. Voilà, c'est ça. Encore une fois, on le refait une fois à 23, parce que c'est
once more 23
que
because
que soit continue.
It's important that this thing continue.
1, 2, 3. Et vous diminuez. Voilà, c'est ça, très bien, merci. Et le troisième plan,
the third level,
qui joue des accords espacés,
for the strings which play spaced chords, which simply
certains passages,
underline certain passages in the phrases.
Vous attendez, première mesure,
you wait, first measure, second measure, start.
Pas trop piano, parce qu'autrement vous ne pourrez plus faire le diminuendo.
Not too piano, otherwise you won't be able to play the diminuendo.
Dans son œuvre, Schoenberg a
in his piece, Schoenberg has overlaid the three levels simultaneously.
Et la polyphonie peut être alors comparée à une conversation.
Can be compared to a conversation.
Une comparaison classique.
A comparison that was going on in Bach's time.
La polyphonie,
Bach's polyphony is a conversation, just as Schoenberg's polyphony is. Once more, mainly don't be afraid to mark your presence. Both of you, compared to the clarinets. Naturally you're under, but you shouldn't be too timid either. One last time.
Voilà le début d'une pièce qui s'intitule
Here's the opening of a piece entitled Romance Without Words. The allusion to Mendelssohn is obvious.
Et cette mélodie qui est jouée par
This melody played by the violin
est une mélodie accompagnée à la clarinette basse
is accompanied by the bass clarinet and the guitar.
C'est-à-dire que cet accompagnement n'est pas loin du tout de l'accompagnement typique des romances
of the romantic period.
Seulement transformé avec d'autres notes, ce qui donne on peut penser qu'il y a beaucoup de
Schoenberg felt considerable nostalgia when he used the mannerisms of that period, perceptively, but also sentimentally.
Thank you. Dans le second mouvement du concerto de chambre
d'Alban Berg, in the second movement of Alban Berg's chamber concerto,
on a un violon solo,
there is a violin
et des
solo,
instruments avant qui l'accompagnent.
And the wind instruments accompany.
Le violon solo commence par une très longue mélodie.
The violon solo begins
et
with a very long melody composed
comme un poème en vers.
Like a poem
il
in
y a d'abord
verse.
Un premier vers.
There is a first verse
composé de quatre notes
made up of four notes.
Et puis un deuxième
then
vers
a second made up
qui est formé de notes
of shorter notes.
À quoi répond exactement
to which the,
la deuxième phrase?
Second phrase answers.
Qui est composé du troisième et
which is composed of the third
enfin
and fourth verses, and finally the fifth and sixth verses, or the third phrase.
La première phrase est accompagnée
the first
par les
phrase is accompanied by the brasses.
La deuxième phrase
the second phrase
se révèle
is
par
revealed by
les clarinettes,
clarinettes,
une sonorité
a completely
complètement
different
différente.
Quality of sound.
Et la troisième phrase
and
est signalée par l'emploi du hautbois et flûte,
the oboes
c'est-à-dire
flutes,
une troisième sonorité.
A third sound.
Ainsi, non seulement
thus we understand not only the articulation of the phrase, but also its color.
Cette mélodie qui a été
exposée violon,
vous avez entendu
heard in its entirety.
Quand Berg la reprend,
when Berg picks it up later
œuvre,
in the work,
vers la fin
toward
la
the end
partie,
of the first part,
il la reprend, mais divisé. Il ajoute
he
de la couleur.
It. He adds color.
C'est ainsi que le premier vers
so
sera
the
joué
first
toujours
verse
au violon. Premier,
is always
troisième,
by the violin.
Vers sont toujours joués au violon.
The first,
mais le
third
deuxième,
and fifth verses are always played on the violin.
Seront joués par un
but
instrument.
But the second,
avant,
fourth, and sixth are played
clarinet,
by a wind instrument.
Le
first
bois,
the clarinet, then the oboe,
trompette.
And then the trumpet.
Cela a été le violon, maintenant vient la clarinette
now
en réponse.
Clarinet.
De nouveau le violon.
Again the violin for the third verse.
Et le hautbois qui
the oboe answers.
Et le cinquième
the fifth
vers
verse,
le violon.
Still the violin.
À quoi répond la
now answered by the trumpet.
Et donc cette fois-ci,
time,
il a mêlé les deux tones,
the two tones,
à la fois le violon
the violin,
et les instruments avant,
the wind instrument,
dans la mélodie.
Within the melody itself.
Descubra el espectáculo de la imaginación en el Noticiario Cultural 930, conducido por Miriam Moscona y José Gordon, al finalizar la extraordinaria película La infancia de Iván, del cineasta Andrei Tarkovsky.